Hello, hello. So it's Friday. So thank you so much for joining me, and please let me know that you're here. Comment below, type down your question. I'll get to it as soon as I can. But thank you for being here. And I am so happy that it's Friday, but I wanted to talk to you about firecrackers. Sometimes I need a firecracker to do something, get a firecracker on my somewhere sometimes so I can get up and get something done. I don't understand why is it so hard, like whether it's doing dishes or doing laundry or working out or eating right. Sometimes it's just hard. It is as simple as finding that little thing that will flip our own switch inside our brains. So we can actually get up and do something. Sometimes, I guess we just need to get our firecracker ourselves, to force the motivation in. So we're talking about motivation today. Some people say fake it till you make it. Some say faith it until you make it. And I'm not sure if you believe in God or not. I'm not sure if you've read the Bible or not. But in the Bible, God says to us in Psalms 37:5, commit your way to the Lord, trust in Him, and He will act. So to find my own motivation, I've gotten down on my knees and I've asked God for help. I put my desire in His hands because I can't on my own. And I trust in Him, and He helps me go through it whenever I ask Him for help. So that would be the first thing that I would suggest you try. If you believe in God, put your wishes and your desires in His hands. Ask Him to help you go through whatever it is that you're going through, and He will help you. The dictionary says that motivation is the reason that we have for acting or behaving in a particular way, or the general desire or willingness to do something. So what is it that you want to do? What is it that you want to accomplish? What is it that you want? Seriously, what do you want? Me, I want to be fit. I want to lose fat. I want to feel better about myself. I want to wear all those clothes that I have in my closet that don't fit me right now. I want to wear a bikini next summer. Or next time I go to a pool without feeling like I can actually breathe without holding my breath to suck my tummy in. So this is part of my reason or general desire. So what would be your reason? What would be your why? Let me know in the comments below, please. So whatever that is, write it down. I have my journal here. And I write down my goals, and I'm not writing goals such as go hiking up Mount Everest because that would be like beyond impossible right now, and quite expensive too. But climbing my own staircase here in my house without losing my breath, or losing 10 pounds, or eating more vegetables this week, that's more manageable. That's something that you can actually do. The back of my journal says, commit to the Lord in whatever you do, and He will establish your plans. Proverbs 16:3. So there, write your goals down, put them in God's hands, and He will help you with your goals or your plans. He says so in the Bible, and God doesn't lie, okay? Ask others for support. Others can be your best friends, your coworkers, your family, your significant others, maybe your kids. I share my plans with my kid, and now he's helping me, whether by cheering me up, or he is helping me choose healthier foods when we go grocery shopping, or when working out, we do squats together. I hold him in front of me, and we do squats. We help each other with, because he's in karate, and he does sports over the weekend. So we help each other with our push-ups, with our with our sit-ups, with my squats, and he won't let me off the hook. Go to the gym, get a workout buddy, a personal trainer, ask your mom or your sister or your dad. Maybe they will join you too. Challenge yourselves, push each other. Some people can pull this off by themselves. Some people can pull this off with others. Whichever the case may be, ask for someone else to support you in this journey, okay? God has had my back already, but who is going to smack the back of my head when I'm having a cupcake or a donut? See, that's why you need a buddy. You need somebody to support you and help you go through this and this journey. I think you'll agree that it's really hard to go on a road trip with people that you hate in the car. So look at yourself in the mirror. You are those people in the car. You'll have to get along with yourselves and like yourselves and love yourselves if you're going to make it to your destination, okay? It all starts and it all ends with you. And loving yourself at 300, 200, or 100 pounds, that's the most important thing. Hating yourself is not going to help you at all, and it's not going to get you get that far. So work out because you want to take care of yourself. Eat healthier because you love your body and you want it to function better. And you want to feel better. You can have a donut here and there because you want to treat yourself sometimes. There's nothing wrong with it. But that's part of loving yourself, not hating yourself. If you hate yourself, you won't feel motivated to wake up earlier. Do you think your kids feel motivated to do anything when all you do is yell at them? No, they feel motivated to do something because you are nice to them, because you'll get them a reward if they do whatever it is that you ask them to do. So while you're on this road trip to a better you, love yourself every step of the way, every mile, love yourself. Have positive affirmations ready for you every morning. Write them down on a post-it. Stick them to your bathroom mirror. Get a mantra. Work out because you love your body, not because you hate it. I'm breaking through old habits of a behavior and moving on in life. Imagine yourself in 6 months from now. Don't stop. It will be worth it. In Romans 8:37, it says, "Victory in Christ is mine." Psalms 45:13, "I am a beautiful daughter of the King." Ephesians 6:11, it says, "God gives me strength to overcome temptation." So Google weight loss affirmations. Pinterest has tons of them. The Bible has plenty for you as well. Go over your mantra every day. Go over your mantra when you're feeling down. Go over all of these affirmations. You are your first and your last cheerleader. Don't forget that. And give yourself a reward. Make a rewards list. You want a donut at the end of the week? Go get a donut. A donut, one donut, not the whole dozen, okay? You lost 10 pounds, go get a mani-pedi. Put it on your list. You lost 20 pounds, then go get yourself a purse. You lost 40 pounds, get yourself a new workout outfit. It doesn't have to be expensive, but this is something that will motivate you to go to the next goal, something to look forward to. And you feel great because you earned it, literally with sweat and tears, and you won't be lying there. And quit pushing it, quit procrastinating, quit making excuses. You're not fooling anybody but yourself. And I do this all the time, and it's wrong, just plain wrong, because I'm not going anywhere. I'm not getting anything. I'm not accomplishing anything. I'll start on Monday. Well, why not today? I'll start January 1st. Well, why not today? I'll start next month. Well, why not today? I'll start after my vacation. Well, why not today? I'll start when, just go for it. Cut the crap. Start today. Today is a great day, and Monday it'll be a great day. January 1st will be a great day. What's wrong with today? Nothing's wrong with today. Today is it's today. Oh, because I don't have this. You can do push-ups. You can do pull-ups. You can do squats. You don't need anything. You can do that by yourself. You can do jumping jacks. You can do lunges by yourself. You don't have to have any equipment in your house. You don't need to go to a gym. You can just do it in the bathroom before taking a shower. It won't be perfect, but if you lose half a pound in 1 week, if your pants feel looser in 1 week, you're closer to your goal. you're closer than you were before. Before the pants were tighter, and now they're looser. So, I mean, really, you're getting closer and closer. Don't get all these great expectations, okay? Because you may not make it, okay? You're probably expecting 10 pounds, but you're gonna lose maybe 5 pounds, and you're gonna get all down because of it. So don't have any expectations. Best thing to do is not expect anything, but keep working on it. Focus on eating clean. Focus on getting as healthy as you can, one step at a time, 1 mile at a time. Focus on getting at least 20 minutes of exercise, 3 to 5 times in a week. Your body won't play nice with you. Sometimes we are women, we have hormones, we get bloated. The scale doesn't like us sometimes, but the scale is not the last word. You'll have a cookie, you'll have some chips and salsa, you'll have a taco. An extra one, maybe. You'll have more calories in one day than you should have. So what? It is life. You are human. You give yourself a chance. Cut yourself some slack, and be nice to yourself. I often tell my kid not to say that he's trying. I'm trying to do this. I'm trying to do that. You're either doing it or you're not. You're either losing weight. You're getting healthier, you're working out, you're doing it, and you're not perfect. It's not gonna be perfect. But if you repeat on day two what you did on day one, if you repeat on day three what you did on day two, if you repeat what you did on one day, on the next day, over and over and over, then you're making a habit, you're making a routine. And then eventually you'll do it with your eyes closed. Don't overcomplicate stuff. Don't make it hard. Make it easy for you to follow your own steps, okay? Put it down on a piece of paper. Mondays and Wednesdays, you eat this and this, you eat this and you do this workout. On Tuesdays and Thursdays, you are going to do this and this. Fridays, maybe a Monday again, or half Monday and half Tuesday. Saturday probably will be a lighter workout, but you're not complicating it, okay? And you're follow your own plan. So just enjoy your road trip. Help yourself to succeed. Stay motivated. Keep persisting to wellness, and trust me, we'll get there. And by the way, this week I lost 3 pounds, and I've been working out a little bit more this week. So I want to thank you for joining me. Please let me know again if you have any questions. If you have a comment, just type it down below. I will get to it as soon as I can. Please like this video, love this video. You'll have a great weekend. Be safe. Enjoy your family, your friends, your kids. Pray to God. Go to church. And eat right, sleep right, move right, and live right. See you soon. Bye.